Jamile. Huh? Jamile. Jamile. Okay, my sister.
Jamile.
Jamile. No, sis. Before Columbus came on that island, right? What language were the so-called Boricuas, the Puerto Ricans, they call today? What was their language? They were Columbus, what the ships called the Santa, Nina, and Peter, when Columbus rolled up on the shores, they did the Arawaks and the Caribbean people said, Correstas. No, they did not.
That's right.
So what was their language?
They were
native because all those people from South Central America, the entire Americas,
yep.
They're the same people. Okay, I'm going to show you something about that word, Boricua. Boricua comes from a Hebrew word.
That's right.
Borican, which means brave lord.
That's right.
You heard that? Borican means brave lords. Borica is brave lords. Borican is land of the brave lords.
Right.
The people in Puerto Rico call their land that. That is an Hebrew word.
Right.
Why won't the people in Puerto Rico be speaking Hebrew? Why? You know why? Because they are.
That's right.
They are the Hebrews of the Bible.
Right.
That's why when Columbus came there, he had Hebrew translators. It wasn't Spanish translators. Columbus is an Italian that sailed to this side of the earth under the authority of Isabella and King Ferdinand of Portugal, right?
Spain.
Of Spain,
right.
Yeah. No, sis. He knows Spanish, he knows Italian, he knows Portuguese. Why would they bring translators? Because the people that they know they will encounter will speak another language.
Right.
In school, how did they tell that the natives reached this side of the earth? What did they say? Slavery. But there's a theory that's installed in the so-called schools that we go to, that they came over here on the Bering Strait. You ever heard that? The ice bridge from Europe and all that nonsense? That is not true. Your people came over here on ships.
Right.
Thousands of years ago. And guess what? They know where they were going. That is why when Columbus came this side, he was not going to India.
Right.
He knows where he was going. And he knows who lives here. I'm going to show you that. And read that.
This is the book, The Two Promised Lands, The Origins of American Racism by Ronald Sanders.
So this is a good book called The Two Promised Lands because America is called, find it and read it. But this is your history. Listen to this, read.
Eventually, a canoe appeared bearing these men and women, all of them Indians, to the place where Francisco and Montezinos were standing at the water's edge. The woman got off and spoke to Francisco in an Indian tongue that Montezinos could not understand, although he could perceive that he was being identified in the conversation. She then turned to her male companion to explain the situation. Upon hearing her words, they rose, went over to Montezinos, and to his utter astonishment, she said, Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, which is translated, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one.
Now sis, you heard that? That's what they greet them with. They were speaking Hebrews.
That's right.
They were speaking in Hebrew language to show you that these people, they are Hebrews. They are the chosen people. They are the Israelites of the Bible.
That's right.
How is it that they came to this land and why? We're going to get that. Get me Ezra 14. I'm going to show you. There is no Bering Strait that they teach our kids. Hey, young man, listen up. Come closer. Though we're going to touch Halloween, but listen to this. This is your history. There is no, that Bering Strait theory in high school is dead.
Right.
There is no proof of none of that.
Right.
This is all the so-called Native Americans, the so-called inside of the word.
Hey.
And somebody find the answer it. Okay, read that.
This is the book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 13, verse 40.
Read.
Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king.
Now, the 10 tribes is talking about from Ephraim and Dan. Okay, sis, you paying attention? The 10 tribes, they're called the Northern Kingdom of Israel because these 12 tribes were one nation. But you're familiar with Solomon, King Solomon? After King Solomon died, his son rose up. And what happened? There was a split in the nation.
Right.
One people go with one, with Ephraim and Dan, that's 10 tribes. And three went with Judah, Benjamin and Levi. That's why you have the so-called blacks and Hispanic divided now. Because the one that went to Judah, Benjamin and Levi, they're mostly African Americans, West Indians, and Asians right now. Those 10 tribes are consist of now mainly of the Northern Kingdom, which is the so-called Hispanics, Native American, the Seminole Indians.
Right.
That was the 10 tribe is talking about here. It says what, read?
Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Salmaneser, the king of Assyria, led away captive, and he carried them.
So, my sister, do you understand what we're reading? Like, are you a little confused? You understand what's going on?
Makes sense.
What, so far, what do you understand so far? I can't hear you, I'm sorry. Can you come a little closer? We don't bite, we don't got COVID, we're all right. What do you understand so far?
That you don't have to worry about every one of these tribes
came from one original tribe.
What was the root tribe? That
one of the parts. Well, okay, see what I'm saying? Y'all going too fast. We are, you know what I'm saying? We are Israel. According to the Bible, black people and Hispanic people are Israelites.
Right.
We are the real Jews.
Right, right.
You see the Jews that they used to make us cry for in school during the Holocaust, and they're not the real Jews.
That's right.
The real Jews are black people and Hispanic.
Right.
I know it made you cry. They made you feel it. But according to the scriptures, Columbus did Hispanic people worse than Hitler did Jewish people.
Right.
Listen to me. Listen to me. What was question? Here's my question to you. Where you from on the side? Where you from?
My family, we're from Puerto Rico.
You're from Puerto Rico. Okay. But where Puerto Rico come from? Where'd the name come from? You don't know. You know what I'm saying? You have to break it slow. Come on, you're going too fast.
Okay.
Okay, all prejudices. Now we're going to slow it down. Puerto Rico. Port. Rico. Port of riches, right? That's what it is. That's what it is.
Right.
Translated in
English is port of riches. That's why they named that place when they went there. That's what they saw. When you read it, I think it's in the same book. It tells you when the so-called Spaniards came, they see the kids playing with diamonds on the beach.
Right.
That's why they call it a port of riches.
Right.
It was a treasure for Spain. Okay? Now, the officer brought up what Columbus did to the so-called Puerto Ricans, the Hispanic tribes, was worse than what the so-called Jewish man went through, because they're not the Jews.
Right.
You know what? Look at this. You see these images? This is that's your people. Now look. They would hang them by 13 to represent the 12 apostles of Christ, right?
Right.
They would burn them at the stakes. Their babies was taken from them and their heads smashed against rocks.
I don't like that.
Listen, sis, a lot of us don't like it, but guess what?
Right.
This is our history.
Right.
Over 70 million died. How much people died in the Holocaust, my brother? How much people died in the so-called Jewish people Holocaust? How much they say died? They estimated to be 6 million.
Right.
That's what they claim. We don't know, but guess what? You know how much
people died in 6 million?
Sis, do you know how much of your people died?
Bring it out.
Bring it out.
Over 70 million.
Right.
plus the ones that they brought as slaves to Spain. When Columbus went back to Spain, you know what he filled those three ships with? Slaves.
Right.
The cargo going back was gold and slaves.
Right.
So the Hispanic tribes was the first slaves.
Right.
When they kill so much of you guys and conquer you, they come and get us on the western coast of Africa. But that's what we're trying to bring out, right? In the book of Ezra, Ezra chronicled that your people will come to a new land where never mankind dwell. We're going to read it for you. Listen up close. Read.
This is the book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 13, verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Shalmaneser the king of Assyria led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and so they came into another land. But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt.
It says the 10 tribes said they will leave. They were here. Okay? Get a better map. They were here in this area. They said they're going to leave and go in a further country where never mankind dwelt.
Right.
Do you know that at that time, there was nowhere like that? Only they know the Most High gave them the vision. Read on.
No. But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt, that they might there keep their statutes which they never kept in their own land.
It says they might keep their laws, their statutes that they never kept while they were in captivity. See, but, I want you to look at this. You see this? Look at the ending of their garments, their clothing. What's that? You see this thing?
Bring it up!
Tassels. You know, in the Bible, that's called fringes.
Right.
That is a commandment. Just as we are wearing now. You see this? You see that? It is a commandment in the Bible. Hold that. And let's get numbers. I'm going to show you that when we read, they said they're going to go into another country where mankind never dwells, so they can keep their statutes and their laws. This is one of them. Read that.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 38. Speak unto the children of Israel and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments.
So say, you see this? This is fringes in the borders of their garments. Read.
Throughout their generation, and that they put upon the fringe of the border a ribbon of blue.
So that was one of the commandments.
So that's our nationality. Just to let you understand, so we can make it easier for you to get. Puerto Ricans are black too. You understand that?
What?
No, listen to me, sis. Many of our Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, when you ask them, are you black? They say, oh, hell no. No black, no negro. You know what I'm talking about. They some are Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Cubans, Colombians, Salvadorians. A lot of them think they're white. Give me that scripture. I want to tell you something.
They don't understand
it. Give me Jeremiah that oppressed together. Give me that scripture. I want you to understand that. You understand, sister? Sister, you understand. You brother, you understand that, right? Many of our Puerto Ricans and Dominicans be black as hell and tell you that they're not black.
Right.
Many of our Puerto Ricans, Dominicans,
Cubans. Who we talking about? People from Panama. They'll tell you, hey, I'm not black, I'm Spanish.
Bring it out.
What the hell does that mean? What does that mean? I'm not black, I'm Spanish. Here's a new class of my Puerto Rican, Dominican, Hispanic. People from Spain don't claim you.
Right.
You understand that, right? Remember that. The people from España, the Spanish, they don't claim Hispanics and Latinos. They think y'all are the niggas that speak Spanish.
Right.
I'm dead serious.
Right.
Read this.
This is the book of Jeremiah.
Let me tell you something.
Chapter 50, verse 33. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel,
the Latinos,
and the children of Judah,
the black people,
were oppressed together.
We were oppressed together. We were made slaves together. You understand that, right?
Right.
It ain't no accident that it's blacks and Hispanics and it's the Bronx.
Right.
That is the most diverse, because we the same people.
Right.
You might as well claim that you're black, because y'all say nigga more than black people.
Right.
Am I right, sis? Come on, be real. Come on, sis. Y'all say nigga more than black people. I'm like, damn. I'm like, what's going on here?
Bring it out.
Let's understand that we're the same.
Right.
And we the Israelites at the end of the day.
Right.
We are the Israelites, the 12 tribes. And we're here to prophesy against the lies out here.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.